So now that we have a couple of the tables created by importing the data or by creating the data from scratch, at this point I'm going to talk a little bit about adding data to those tables, formatting them, and then I'm going to get into linking those tables together so that we can perform queries and also run reports and get the data from various tables. For example, one piece, for example, get the customer first name and last name from the customer's table, then go and get, for example, the contracts for each customer from the contracts table, and then invoices as well from the invoices table. So in order for us to perform that, we have to link the tables before we can do these queries. So first, we have here the table customers, and to add a new record, even though this is not recommended in a business environment, but if you had to, this is how you add a new record. You go to the very bottom or anywhere here, and notice you can go from one record to the other by clicking on this next icon. You can also go to the very end, the last record, by clicking here, or creating a new record by clicking on this icon here. And then simply type in there. You can search by simply typing a name, and it will bring up wherever that specific name shows up. There are a couple of ways to do this differently as well that we'll cover in a little bit. Now, I mentioned earlier one of the key components here in an Access database is the ability to link those tables together. So in order to link tables and establish a relationship between the various tables, you need to have established first those primary keys and foreign keys. That's where planning comes into play and it becomes very important. So you have, for example, the customers table. If we go under the home tab and we click here or right click on the customers table and choose design view, notice the primary key is customer ID for the table customers. Now if we go, for example, under contracts, notice if we go under design view, I'm right clicking here and choosing design view. We have contract number that is the primary key. However, notice there is also a customer ID. What that is saying is that when we are recording the contracts, we are not necessarily recording the first name, last name of each customer. We are just putting the customer ID from the customer's table. And that is in the customer's table, the customer ID is the primary key, as we saw a moment ago. Now here, the primary key here, notice this golden key here on the left, for this table, it's a contact number. So the customer ID in this case, it's actually what's referred to as a foreign key. The foreign key is basically a common field between two tables or two lists. In this case, it's a common field, but it's not the primary key on the second table. In other words, you have customers that have contracts, and each customer can have more than one contract. Same idea is for the invoices as well. If we right-click and choose design view here, we have the invoice number, which is the primary key, but then we have the contract number, which is linked to the contracts table. To establish a relationship, this is a very important concept whenever you're designing databases and we are creating more than one table, is that you have to link those tables together. And this is where most of the students fail in their project. One thing before I actually go ahead and link those tables, it's important that whatever data type that the primary key uses on the first table, the same thing needs to be on the foreign key needs to match. So basically, the foreign key here is customer ID needs to be the same data type as the primary key of the corresponding table. So now let's go ahead and link those tables. To link them, you go under Database Tools, and then you click on Relationships. Notice it says relationships. It defines how the data in tables is related, such as the ID in a field or the name in fields, how they match. So I'm going to pick all the tables. So we just click on each one of those, contracts, customers, and then invoices. We add them all to the board, basically. Now notice we have customers here and the customers, customer ID, it's the same field under the contacts table. So what we do is we drag the customer ID under customer ID under the contacts table. Now when we drag it, it's a one-to-many relationship. That means that one customer can have many contacts. Now there are ways as well to enforce what's called referential integrity, and I'm not going to confuse you too much with this, but that means basically that if you go ahead and remove a customer for some reason, then it should drop all the contacts as well. In the case of students, if a student has signed up for courses for a semester, however they leave the university, then the system should also drop the courses that they have signed up for. Basically that you update one record or you delete one record, it should delete the other ones to cascade down. For now, for simplicity, I'm going to keep that off. We click on create, and notice now we have this line. It's telling us that customer ID here is the primary key, and this is the foreign key on the next table. Now under invoices, notice the common field here. We don't have here customer ID. So customers is not related to invoices directly. What we have is that from each contract we generate invoices. So what we do here is we have contract number and contract number. Notice that's the primary key, that's the foreign key here. So what we do is we drag the contract number to contract number down here. So make sure you drag it directly on the name of the foreign key. And then notice it's going to be a one-to-many relationship. So it means it's one contract with many invoices. And then we click on create. And then you can kind of move this either way, however you want to arrange it. And then the key here is to click on close and then save this relationship. Now these tables are linked together. What that means is that if I wanted to pull, for example, the names of the customers, first name, last name, and then the actual contracts, I can do that at this point once the tables have been linked. At this point, let me show you how you can actually create a query. Go under the Create tab, and then we click on the Query Wizard. That's the easiest one. I'd recommend for whatever you do when you're using these databases and you're learning some of the basic concepts, use the wizard component. So click on Query Wizard. And then what you do is choose simple. And notice we have the table customers. So the way it works is that you can pick and choose. So you say, I want the first name. You pick the next field, you add it to the right hand side. And let's say I want just their email. So that's from the customers table. Now let's say I want to go to the contracts table, and let's say I want the contract number, amount, and let's say I want the type. So that's all I want. A query is basically a set of criteria that you want. So now I click on next, and then we click on next again, and then we give it a name. Then I click on finish. And notice the system generated, notice you can actually resize these. The system generated, based on our criteria, created a new list. And this is a query based on those tables. If you remember, each of these tables has only pieces of this information, but it's because they are linked together through that relationship we established earlier and through the primary keys and foreign keys that we can generate a query here with data from two tables. And you can do this with more than two tables if they are linked correctly. How about creating a form where we can enter the data into a table? So to create a form, we simply go under create, and then we can choose the form wizard. So let's say I want from the customers table, I want to add all of these fields. You can do them all in once by this double arrow here. And then I want to also add the invoices. Let's say I want to add the invoice number, the date, amount. Then I click on next, click on next again, next. And this is our form. So basically here, what we are doing is we are entering. So let me close it first. So once we close it, we save this. And notice we have customers form. There's also a subform for that. That's because we link to a subtable. If we open the customers form, notice we have the customer ID, the name, and also all the invoices for that customer. So for example, Owen here with this address has these invoices. And this is pretty much how most databases work. Now notice we have 39 customers, and you can scroll from one customer to the other by this navigation bar here in the bottom. And also you can create a new customer by clicking on this new record here in the bottom. So when you create a new customer, you can also create a new invoice for them. So that's what's referred to as a compound form. Again, the concept here is that you can create forms once the tables have been linked together. So to create a report, you can again use here the wizard. So the report wizard under create and then report wizard. And then let's say we want customers. Let's say we want customer first name, last name. Then we want to go under the contracts, and then we want to get the amount and the type. So let's say that's all we need for our report. We click on next, next again, next here, and then finish. Under the summary options, you can actually define as well the amount. So you can get a sum of the amount there, or the minimum, maximum, and so on. So if you wanted that, the way I did that was by clicking on summary options here and then choosing just the sum. You can also sort the data by amount, and then we click on next, then next again, and then let's say we wanted customer report. The names here, you'd make them meaningful names so that you, when you see 50 items in there, you'd know what they mean. So we click on finish. And notice we have for Owen here, he has these contracts, and the total comes to 7,750. So you can format these reports to look even nicer than this, but again, notice it looks nicer than the query. The query looked something like this, just state data, and the report, well, it's designed so it can be printed out with a date and all that type of stuff.